Hi everybody, Joey Krys here with Professional Contractor Supply with another PCS Safety update. Today's topic is the inspection of an 11 millimeter Kernmantle rope, sometimes known as a 7/16 rope, and the components that go on it. That would be the rope grab and the shock pack. I was asked by solar and roofing companies, what's the best, most durable, long-lasting, safest rope we can get our hands on? And we came up with this, and let me tell you why. At 11 millimeters, it's half the diameter of the 3/4 or the 5/8 ropes that you would typically see. This reduces trip hazards. Also, with those taller diameter ropes, sometimes your foot could travel over it and you could actually end up with an ankle injury. Not good when you're on the top of a roof. Now, let's talk about why we like this rope and the design of this rope. This black tight weave cover is over a white nylon core. What this cover does is it's UV resistant, it's abrasion resistant, and more importantly, it's chemical resistant. Remember, we have sealants on top of the roof, and if that gets on the outer cover, we don't want it to degrade it. That's what works great. Also, when this rope is wet, it works beautifully. The last thing is that this rope is rated at 7,000 pounds. Okay, now that we know why we want this rope, let's look at the features of the things we have to do to inspect the rope. Okay, here we go, time to inspect the rope. So for me, I like to start from the top and work my way down. That way we don't forget anything. So at the top, we have our double locking connector. We have to verify that it is indeed a double locking connector. If I put pressure on this front gate, we don't want it to open. Two functions to get it to work. So we push the back and then pull it forward and it opens. Once it's there, we want to let go and make sure it shuts all the way. We want to make sure that there's no rust or corrosion on this metal, which is also why we never want to engrave into the metal. That could promote that rust from happening. Okay, down below we actually have a swivel. This should swivel all the way around. If it stops or gets corroded, it means there's a problem and we might have to fail the rope. If we drop down a little bit farther, you're gonna see a protective coating here. That is a sheath over the information tag. This will tell us the manufacturer, the serial number, the date it was made. These are all important information things we have to write down when we inspect our gear twice a year by a competent person and every single time by the user before they use it. Now, once we've got past that, we wanna grab our hands onto the rope. We visually wanna inspect it looking for cuts. And what we're going to do is put our hands all the way around it, all the way down, keep on looking at it. We're also checking for sealant or a chemical that might be on the rope. We might be able to clean it right off. We will work our way all the way to the end. Some of the things you want to worry about at the end, we want to make sure we don't have terminations that look like this. This is the nylon core coming out. If you see this nylon or white color in any part of the rope, it means that would constitute a failure. Okay, now let's move on to the rope grabs. So time to inspect the first of the two rope grabs that actually work on this 11 millimeter rope. This particular device is made by Safeways and actually has an ANSI approval on it. Now, first thing we want to do is check the front and we want to check the back to make sure there's no dents, corrosion, or sealant that might hinder it from working properly. On this particular device, you will see there is an up arrow that is telling us where our anchor is. Now, what we do is we open it up and there's only one moving part, this spring-loaded device right here. After that, we want to go ahead and connect it to the rope. If we lift this up, bring this down, bring it into the rope, shut it, we're in good shape as this goes up and down the rope. You'll also notice on the bottom here again, this is the lockout device in case we want to use this in a fall restraint device, means that we're locking it onto the rope and setting it so we can't fall off the roof. We're going to inspect our 11 millimeter rope grab. Here we're going to check the front and we're going to check the back to make sure that there is no corrosion. As you will see, there was an arrow pointing up. That is telling you that is where the anchor point is going to be. Once we open up the device, we want to make sure that the springs are in good working order. In this case, we pull them both back up and you can actually see where that rope is going to go. Once the unit is shut, you bring it all the way down and you would connect your connector on there and attach the rope grab. Okay, time to inspect the shock pack. Now, before we connect it to our Safeways or Kong grab, we have to make sure it's in good working order. Make sure that this round D-ring is indeed round. If it was oblong, it means it might have been loaded. Again, we want to double check the hook to make sure it's in good working order. We open it, shut it, it should shut all the way. Make sure there's no corrosion on it. Next thing we want to do is make sure the tags are in good working order, front and back. This is a protective coating over the shock pack itself. If this had been elongated, you would know that it's been loaded and it was time to fail. We're going to talk about how to connect the three components properly when you're using it on the system. First, our rope grab that travels up and down. We're going to take the carabiner and connect it onto the rope grab. That is the only connection that is meant to go on here. As you will see, the carabiner is connected to the round part of the shock pack. We are not connecting the double locking hook. This would go onto the back of the harness of the user. As he moves up the rope, this will travel with him and lock down if necessary. Okay, now that we've successfully inspected all of our gear, there's a couple things you have to keep in mind. One, we have to put a termination at the end of the rope. This will prevent that rope grab from actually sliding off the end of the line. Two, we do not want to use the line as a lifting line, meaning we do not want to lift product up onto the roof with it, as this will prematurely wear the rope. Remember, this is a component of a vertical lifeline system. We need to save it for that. Also, if you have any questions about anything you saw in this video, if you'd like to see testing criteria, if you'd like to see a drop test video, if you'd like to see the ANSI approval, or you simply just want to buy the line, make sure you contact me with the information at the end of the video. And as usual, have a safe day.